Hey, you want to go talk?
Yeah, let's do it.
So how are you feeling with all of this? I feel like it'd be really overwhelming.
Those are not nice chairs. It's those are not press size, plus size friendly chairs, Alex. Hello, beautiful people. It's Mama Goob. So I want to circle back and take a peek at Alexandra Rodriguez's dating show. I started doing a reaction to them a while ago. I had been planning on catching up while she was on maternity leave, but that did not happen. I still want to see the rest of these, and some of you do too. And since my schedule has been crazy lately with work, I'm trying to knock out a bunch of filming on the weekend. So you'll see me in this look a lot in my upcoming videos. But without further ado, let's see what's going on in episode 3. Why not?
Welcome back to another day of Curvy Connection. On our last episode, we got to see Luis form some strong connections on his first one-on-one dates. Today, we're going to be heading on a few group dates.
She's not wearing another bra again.
Where Luis can really spend some more time with the girls and start to think about who he wants to take on his one-on-ones tomorrow. We're going to be starting the day off with a group cooking class and a pool party in the afternoon.
We did a group cooking class for a team building event at work. Oh my God, it was so much fun. I couldn't believe it.
Let's check in with Luis and see how he's feeling today. Thank you so much, Chic Soul, for sponsoring Curvy Connection. You can get 20% off your ChicSoul.com order with code CurvyConnection. So I already gave Luis the rundown on how today is going to go. After processing everything last night, how are you feeling after yesterday?
Feeling really good. Yesterday went so good. Just the date with Jules was... It was a really good connection. I couldn't have planned it better myself. And so it was just, it was organic. There was just like this good vibe. I don't know. She just puts me at a place of peace, and it's
place of peace.
It's really refreshing.
I know you've had like a little bit of time to get to know the girls off camera and on the first night at the cocktail party. Who else are you initially excited to get to know more today?
I think I'm really excited to get to know Aubrey more. I think just her personality just would really mesh well with mine, I think. And we have some commonalities as well. And so I'm really excited to just kind of
I don't
dig
remember.
Deeper into that and just learn more about her and see where that leads.
Perfect. Let's head to the group cooking class and see how the connections unfold. Okay, so the girls are getting ready, and we've caught a little chitty chat connection with Aubrey, who he's interested in getting to know. So, don't you wonder, what are they talking about?
They're talking about you, later. Alex. All right, so this is her intro. Fun. Yeah, this is like the yep. And then we had to wear aprons. It was a lot of fun when we did this. And it was a big group of us. So we did this one. We were making, still music. We were making, what did we make? Pasta. We made handmade pasta. And at one point they had a...
It wasn't a fight.
They had a big sheet of pasta that, like, the 20 of us held. It was hysterical.
Just, I feel like we're very, like...
It's bold personality.
We all have, like...
And we all have opinions.
Yes. And we're, like, powerful when it comes to, like, speaking our mind. And I think a lot of times it just doesn't get communicated right. There were some questions asked. And I think it was just, like, it came off kind of weird. And, like, the answer was not... what the question was about, so...
Obviously, it wasn't about...
I think the other girls like the drama more than the people that were involved. But,
yeah, they have
so
to have drama.
So last night, it was a little tip with the girls. So Jules was
Aubrey.
Recapping her one-on-one date with Luis, and everybody was very excited. I was a fan, obviously.
Obviously.
And it was very interesting because I was under the assumption that we were all like rooting for each other, and I think that was the case. I was joking with Val, and I was like, Val, you seemed a little pressed, because every time Jules kept talking about her date with Luis and how it went well and then the little kiss, Val was like, oh, well, that's so cool, but like, you know, everybody will still have a chance. You like never know, which I think is amazing because you never do know. I haven't been on my one-on-one date yet, so I'm very excited to see what happens. But after like the third or fourth time, I was like, oh, so I was like making a joke and I was like, are you pressed? I'm like, because it seems like you're a little jealous. And I'm like, if that
pressed is jealous,
cool, call a spade a spade. But I don't think.
So I know jealous. I know let's call a spade a spade. But I've never heard it being called pressed before. But okay.
She didn't react the way I thought she would. But I also think it was a little bit of a confirmation. I don't know. But then we hashed it out. We had a good talk. And she was just kind of just like, I want to root for everyone. And she was like, I think everybody is great, which I think was okay. But I do think, in all honesty, it was a little bit of jealousy because it's sick.
You know, I love us women. And I can tell you, I'll call a spade myself. Women can be very competitive. I actually do not prefer to work for women. I prefer to work for men. But I mean, I'm good either way, actually, but it can get competitive.
Five girls in a house with one guy as our main hottie, so you never know.
It was definitely a miscommunication. The delivery was, I understood what she was saying. I think her delivery maybe came off a little too aggressive, and so then, naturally, as a person, you kind of want to defend yourself. I'm here for the girls, and I know that Luis is going to find whoever he wants at the end of the day. I think that I was mostly...
And the spoiler alert is I don't think he really ended up with any of them.
Speaking on behalf of all the girls, and I was saying, you know, he hasn't had his other one-on-ones with all the other girls, and I think that he's trying his best to connect with every individual. And so that's all I was trying to deliver. And again, we're all very strong-minded, beautiful ladies, and I think we all clash in a sense, but we all get along. And at the end of the day, it was all out of love. And
you guys are all frenemies. It's okay. It is what it is.
And those are my girls.
All right. More shitty music. And this, that blonde hair girl kind of stays out of it, doesn't she? Boy, they're making them really work. We didn't get to put anything on the stove. We mostly chopped and laughed and drank wine.
You want a tour? We have the best for the first.
Rustic
thick. Thick grapes.
Coco Von.
Insert name here. Okay.
Coco Von. Coco Von.
Yum. And then we have to wrap it up.
Taters. So we have a butter lettuce salad with beets, extra beets, because they didn't want their beets, and goat cheese, and sunflower seeds.
I hate beets. And then it's like crepe. Eating dirt. She spent the bucks in music, huh? So, they're making them stand. They're making them stand and eat. And we also did learn the proper way to chop an onion, which...
The difference between their grapes. This is like gourmet level grapes. Voila.
We do it big over here.
Don't forget we like it to look a little rustic.
So did you get a chance to talk to anyone on the cooking date?
So I didn't really get a chance to talk to people, but I definitely felt like there were like connections made. Like I was able to be like, hey, like encouraging and like welcoming them to do more things. I don't know. It was fun. And I got to like see working with somebody, like being able to be a teammate. That's super important for me in a relationship.
Bullshit.
So like the fact that we weren't like bumping heads, it was good.
No, get out of the kitchen. If I'm cooking, get out of the fucking kitchen.
That was really helpful. Like, and she was very interested in trying things. You know, I think Fatima was very reserved, which is fine. I think it may not have been her wheelhouse for sure. It may not have been her like strong suit, but she still interacted. You know, she was still like there and like doing her stuff. And so like,
she was there.
Maybe it could have been a little bit more affirming.
So I saw you got to talk a little bit to Aubrey before the date. Did you talk about anything interesting?
We were just talking about different shows and like what we do.
They're talking about TV.
If I'm completely honest, it kind of felt, you know, like
I've never met a guy that wants to talk about TV.
Like somebody that you would be on a date with. I definitely want to, you know, spend more intentional time
like
doing that.
Even coworkers. We've never talked about TV.
It's a little different. They left here yesterday and I was just so like, to be honest, I was smitten with her. I was just very taken by her. And it was so good. Today, she feels a little distant, a little cold. And it's hard. It is a little hard because I'm just like, cold. Well, what's going on? I don't know what the reasoning is behind that.
Imagine having to guide imagine having to gauge how you're acting at every moment. It's got to be draining. I mean, I know this is a show and all.
A fluke or that she has her reasons behind that. So I guess we'll find that out.
I want to see how the sit-down views.
Everything's going really well so far. We just came back from the cooking class. We're getting ready for the pool party. I feel really, like, calm, weirdly, which is very abnormal for me. I feel like I'm just getting comfortable with everybody and, like, kind of coming out of my shell a little bit, which good. I feel like people from home are going to be like, you don't have a shell. But I think being around a lot of other bold people has made me a little bit more reserved. But now I feel like I'm comfortable and, like, can talk to them and be as crazy and wild and outspoken and honest as I want. It was super fun during the cooking class. I feel like I learned a new skill. I'm excited to hang by the pool. I'm such a pool girl. So we're excited. I feel good. Honestly, everybody's been so awesome. So I just feel excited to like continue this experience and see where everything goes.
Wow, this is really pretty pool. I wonder if it's heated. That's so cute. This is some of Alex's decorations that she had left over. They're all going to do their bathing suit reveal, which is nice. Oh my God, that looks dangerous.
One size fits all.
Yeah, those chairs look like fun too. Who wears denim to the pool, though?
I wasn't sure. I'm a germaphobe sometimes.
Oh.
A little bit. Oh, that's very Malibu with like pineapple juice.
Yum. Malibu rum? Mm-mm.
It's refreshing. It's lighter.
I like sugary stuff. I don't drink.
Mm. It's good,
right? Can ask anybody.
I like it. Hey, you want to go talk?
Yeah, let's do it.
So how are you feeling with all of this? I feel like it'd be really overwhelming.
Those are not nice chairs. Those are not plus-size-friendly chairs, Alex.
Thanks.
And just, yeah, you guys are all really fun.
Yeah.
It's cool to see, like, everyone in there, like, everyone shine at their own, like, pace, you know, at, like...
Yeah.
Like, it was cool to see you out, like, cooking.
I feel like I was very quiet, weirdly.
Today?
Right. No, you actually did. Yeah, I mentioned before. That.
Sure, but today you were actually like really
I feel like I finally like calmed down.
Yeah,
and, like,
it was fun.
Yeah.
It was exciting.
Which I did not think I'd do well at cooking. I thought I'd be the worst one.
Really?
Yeah.
I think you did a great job.
Thank you.
The weather's been really great.
Yeah.
Even when it was rainy, I was like, man, this is awesome. I love it.
I will say I do love a rainy day every once in a while.
Yeah.
It's cozy.
But not when you're going in the pool.
Yeah, you know, it's warm today, but it feels comfortable, you know?
I feel like Georgia's, like, hot. Because I've gone to Savannah once, like, probably 10 years ago. But, like, we did a family vacation down there. And it was great. And so I have experienced it.
Georgia?
We kind of mostly stayed in, like, the old part of town.
Yeah, like, downtown.
Yeah, I know that there's, like, kind of two separate, at least from my understanding. Because my family is sarcastic. And that's how I am too with them.
Because
I think they think in their heads that I'm still like a child.
Right.
Which is fine. I can pull up the receipts of some dumb you guys did at 23 that you were like a full grown adult.
Yeah, that's kind of weird.
I don't know if I felt this like romantic connection. I don't think that there was definite like romance. Like, I don't know.
Yeah, that was an awkward conversation. I don't think I understood where it was going. So, glad they're having fun. It looks like a lot of fun. I need one of those swans. Wonder how she got on it. They even have a little floaty for the drink.
How are you feeling today?
Good. It's been a fun day. I enjoyed like cooking, and now this pool party's really fun.
Pool party's cool.
Feels like you've been a little distant today, which is interesting because yesterday was completely polar opposite, and that's kind of been, it's caught me off guard.
You feel like I've been distant? How do you feel like I've been distant?
I don't know. It just has felt a little colder than what I anticipated.
You feel like I'm being cold towards you?
Maybe.
Or just
and
cold
I don't think
in general.
I don't think you're towards me, maybe.
Really?
Yeah. Which I don't know. Like I'm not. I don't really take offense to it. You know, because I understand.
Oh,
like,
if you didn't take offense, you wouldn't
time,
be mentioning
like,
it.
You know, like it's a bit disorienting.
I've been dating a long time, and I have never dated in a situation where you've got five cute women.
Yeah,
that
they're cute.
You're also trying to get to know. Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm just trying to give the opportunity for everyone to mingle.
But I don't. Sure, I think you can do that and still. I don't know.
You want me to be more assertive?
I don't necessarily want you to be assertive. I just don't want you to like shut down. And that's kind of what it felt like today. I mean, and I'm not saying that to like upset you or anything like
that. No. I
just want you to be aware that
I wish we could see an example of what he's talking about.
I'm interested in you, and I'm interested in like getting to know you, and so like if you're interested in getting to know me, I want to see.
I guess at this juncture the only one he's not really interested in is that blonde.
That
Megan?
Interest.
I think it's a combo of like I want you to be able to, like, I don't know, I want you to be able to get to know other people, obviously. Because sure. I'm interested too, but I'm also, like, confused and this is, like, such a new situation.
No, I get that.
So.
But I would say live in the interest until you're not. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Because, like, this back and forth
fawn
is
over him. Is that
unsettled.
What he's saying?
Not to say the psychic was 100% right, but she had some really good points. I feel like you're, like, such a good guy. This is a different setting. I'm definitely interested. But I just get kind of like
what if
hot and cold.
What if you get on one of these shows and it turns out you're not interested? What happens? Do you go home? Do you fake it? I don't watch
like
these
thinking.
Shows, so I don't know. It Does that ever happen?
That is what I am, and I need to work through that.
Sure.
Because it's true. She was dead on when she was like, as soon as you feel like someone's a good guy, you're going to pull back. 100% accurate. Cool. And that's not cool, but it's honest.
Yeah.
I mean, it really is honest.
I get that. And, like, she did say that.
So, I think I'm at the point where it's just, like, getting to know you and all that. And, like, so I think today I was mostly just trying to, like, let you meet with other people, too. Because I think it's fair.
She's not hogging
for
him.
Them, but also for you. Because there's some good girls here.
Here's the thing. When I'm with you or when I'm with anybody else, I'm giving all of myself in that situation. I'm not thinking about you when I'm with them. And I'm not thinking about them when I'm with you.
I mean, it's different. Like, being here, you know, I'm so used to, like, just being with my kids, working, and this is so different for me.
Oh, yeah.
And it's, like, not me, but also, like, sort of me. Like, it's sort of, like, this is not my life whatsoever anymore. Like, maybe at one point it was.
Yes.
But it's been so fun, and it's, like, I feel like I can just be who I am. It's been really nice. I love this because I feel like we're just, like, human to human.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Do you feel that, too?
Yeah.
Like, I feel like it's different. Like, it's-
Do you think she means she doesn't have to, like, put up a show? Because she absolutely has to put up a show. This is a show.
It's a cool... And
they're
maybe
being
it's just
real.
You know, we all have our insecurities being, like, a little heavier set.
Who is it? Karina Kaboom, when you start dating somebody, you meet their representative? Yeah.
And, like, so I have my own insecurities.
Takes a long
like,
time for your spouse to get to
or
know
whatever,
the real
but
you.
Here has been just, like, nobody cares.
Yeah,
no one cares.
And it's like really refreshing and different.
I think that's what's cool about this environment is that like,
I agree.
You know, because everyone, nobody's sizing each other up. because there's no reason to.
And you're not judging. I mean, it's, yeah, exactly.
When I talked to her, I was like, hey, I need you to either, like, don't hit pause so that other people can catch up. Like, you keep doing you, let me figure that out.
That's true.
Because, I'm interested in you. It's kind of controlling, too. That's what I told her. I was like, I'm interested in her. And so, like, if it feels like you're pulling away, or you tell me you're interested in me and then show me the opposite, like, I don't know what I'm supposed to do in that situation. And, like, that's very off-putting, and it's very, like, it's difficult for me. So, like, even just then, I mean, we had good conversation, but, like, might have felt a little one-sided, or I don't know. Like, that's very, like, I have no idea what she's thinking.
Yeah, I know. I mean, yeah. She called me out for being cold and standoffish today.
Because you guys had such a good connection yesterday, so you were trying to, like, back off, or what?
I don't know.
Are you still confusion?
I'm confused. And I think organically, like, we were in a group setting.
Yeah.
So, like, I want him to be able to get along with everyone else. And I thought that it seemed like a good date.
So magnanimous.
And then he, in the pool, he was just like, I feel like you're not feeling me. I really like you. And you've been kind of standoffish and cold today.
Can't be so hard on yourself, right? Like, it's only been, I mean, it feels like it's forever, right? In two days, it's hard to, like, even, like, if we were, like, online dating ourselves, like, in 2 days, I don't rush, like, right?
Yeah.
So, well, Mr. Amber would read, then you move in.
And, like, get to know people, like, you don't know how it's going to
go. It's a lot of emotions.
You send her a $400 Lego kind of, like, after 2 days.
Do it all, and I don't blame you, I guess, right? I think
I didn't purposely mean to be, like, standoffish.
I think in a group setting, it's, like, harder to be, like, have a intimate, romantic, intimate, like, moment. It's just, like, friends all vibing together.
Yeah, I think he wanted me to, like,
be like, that's my man.
Kinda.
That's my man.
Yeah, he made that comment. He's like, if you're interested, you need to show it. And I'm like, I don't know, it's hard. It's hard.
It's a weird experience, like, having to, like,
well, exactly. I've never been in person. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, like, I'm not saying I'm not interested, but I'm also not, like,
I think
she's sharing.
Now you're like, there's no actual, like, it's like, you're my man. Because
it's like, if you love something, let it free. If it comes back to you, it was meant to be. Maybe that's what she's thinking.
It's so quick. You're like, dude, you're not my man. You're maybe my crush at the moment.
That's bad.
Yeah, I'm enjoying getting to know you. Yeah. I really am. I think it's a wonderful guy. That's a wrap.
Just be like, hey, like, this is a great start.
I'm just trying to be really honest with him. And I just said that I'm sorry that you felt that way. Because I didn't mean to feel that way. And I told him, I'm like, I think you're wonderful. And I like you. But
I tend to shrink in a group too, believe it or not.
He's a cool guy. He was understanding. And he's like, I just want to let you know my feelings.
Yeah.
This is where I'm at. I was like, I appreciate that.
Oh my gosh. This is so pretty.
Have you been down here?
No.
Oh, it's so nice.
I've only been there 2 days. Yeah, it is pretty.
Yeah.
Ours.
Yeah, just please be careful.
Oh,
is it wet?
You. Such a king. Are you having a good time?
I am. I really enjoyed that conversation we had earlier.
I was about to say me too, and I just feel like, as a person of color, it was very refreshing.
Yeah. I'm really enjoying getting to know you.
Thank you. I really am too. I really appreciate, like, the conversation in the pool was really refreshing.
Yeah.
I feel like I saw a different side of you, and I really appreciated it.
Cool. Good. I'm glad.
I wonder what they were talking about.
I mean, you're already, like, great, but, like, I feel like that just opened up a different side, you know?
That stuff to me is very important, you know? So, like, when you were dropping things on, like, the day one, like, anti-capitalist jargon and stuff like that, like, that to me is very, like, it's an attractive thing to hear people say.
This is just me.
Really?
Like, sure. I want to create, it's not even taking away space from anybody, it's creating more space.
Mm-hmm.
And once people realize that's what it is at the end of the day, then we can all get along.
You know, it's funny, like, in the dating world, like, a lot of people would be like, if you could go back in time.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, man, that's such a privileged question.
Right?
And I always respond the same way.
People are like, back. I'm like, can I go in the future?
Yeah, that's what I always.
Looking too good.
I always tell people the past has not been kind to people like me. So I want to go forward to a time when we'll, you know.
Well, you know, why I'd like to go back in the past, you fix stupid shit you did.
Yeah, can we
do the same stupid shit you do? Different stupid shit. Yeah.
Stuff like that in the dating world, where it has sparked some conversation, but has also shut down some conversations. Yeah. And, like, I'm here for it either way. I'm like, I don't want to waste my time on somebody who's not willing to learn.
No, it's me. I can't get rid of it. This is who I am. But exactly. I'm not only fighting for myself, I'm fighting for everybody else. Mm. And it's just plain and simple. And if you're not with that, that's cool. But I'm going to keep
walking with that. Are they all doing
that? Yeah, I love that.
That's just me.
Yeah, I'm really enjoying getting to know you.
Thank you.
He's saying that to everybody. Oh, hey,
let's start with Aubrey. You guys talked for a long time. Like, can you tell me about your talk with Aubrey?
Yeah, I think we caught up on a little bit about, like, the conversation we had in the pool. Just over, like, some just, like, social topics, I guess, you know, and societal topics. And then talked about our bariatric life. Talked about just a lot of stuff. You know, we talked about what it would be like to be in a long-distance relationship, what it would be like to be... I mean, we talked about a lot of stuff. Yeah, it was pretty deep. I think she's attractive. I think she's extremely, like, intelligent and funny and just, like, mature and just, like, fun-loving. And I love all of those qualities about her. But I just... I don't know. I don't know, like... Obviously, well, it's only day two. Like,
how long... I wonder how many days...
One-off conversations. Like, you know, I'd love to interact with her a little bit more and see where that goes. But, like, am I drawn to her romantically? I'm not sure.
What is up, girly pops? So, before I go to sleep, I had to give you all another update, another confessional moment. I'm very excited. There's a lot of emotions going on because it's like so interesting because I've always wanted to be a fly on a wall for a reality TV show. And now we're here. And it's just surreal. But it's also like everyone is vibing so well. But it's also so interesting
because we're
slowly going on one-on-ones with Louise and different vibes are happening. So it's like coming unfolding and I'm very excited because like, you never know what could happen, but it's just like seeing real connections forming with people. I am very excited. Hopefully I'll get to see some time with Louise to see what's the vibe is, how's it going. It's going to be very fun, but this is interesting. I'll keep it at that.
Next time on Curvy Connection.
I'm a lot of the time, and I think a lot of people can't handle me for like more than like small doses.
I do think that like her energy level is, it does not match well with mine.
Are you wanting more kids? What does that look like for you?
You know, they've made some comments like, oh, you're the thinnest one here, and like, and I feel like I get kind of like discredited for it because I don't necessarily like look like everyone else in the house.
Yeah. Because I would hate to be like, hey, I choose you, and then her be like, I don't want to choose you back.
So, yeah, this only got 30,000 views. I'm not going to read the comments on these, but maybe the last one. Well, I don't know. We'll see. Okay, guys. Well, that was it for episode 3. What'd you guys think? Yeah, this is why I don't watch these type of shows. But anyways, Alex did a good job with this. It was very well produced. The music was annoying, but that's okay. Anyways, guys, that's all I have for you today. Thank you so much for stopping by, and I hope to catch you on the next one. Bye.